Hey, North Carolina.
In 2008, two Democrats, Kay Hagan and Barack Obama, won North Carolina thanks to over 70% of the state's black voters turning out.
We're counting on you to help make some history.
This time around, it's just Senator Hagan on the ballot. The challenge is for her and for Democrats across the country in getting black voters back to the polls. Now, on the Election Minute.
Everybody in North Carolina...
In North Carolina, little expense has been spared. Democrats are touting a get-out-the-vote effort with 10,000 volunteers. There's also been a parade of visitors, many very popular in the black community.
Former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was in Charlotte Saturday.
Meanwhile, some of the messaging from Hagan allies has been less than subtle. This flyer was reportedly distributed at an African-American church in Fayetteville. Notice the lynch mob in the background. And a radio ad got instant notice when it evoked Trayvon Martin to criticize the Republican nominee.
Tillis even led the effort to pass the type of stand your ground laws that caused the shooting death of Trayvon Martin.
But remember, white voters still make up 70% of North Carolina's electorate, and they only have a 25% approval rating of the president. As such, the Republican strategy is clear.
If you want to stop the Obama policies, you have to replace Kay Hagan.
For Senator Hagan, she emphasizes her moderate credentials, especially when speaking to a statewide audience.
I think North Carolinians want a common sense voice.
North Carolina, certainly one of the close races of the country for control of the U.S. Senate.
She's walked the tightrope between white and black voters better than most. Some Democrats in a similar position have even refused to say whether they voted for the president.
This election, it isn't about the president.
Senator Hagan has maintained a slight lead and a 6-to-1 cash-on-hand advantage. Despite all that, if North Carolina's black voters don't turn out on Tuesday, it could be an early end to Democrats' hopes of retaining the Senate.